Hi, this is my EUC pedal, and in my previous video, I have already reversed this pedal bracket and lowered it for 25mm. After I reversed this part, I send the files to a CNC service provider, RapidDirect, and today I have already received the part. It takes about 1 month from the day that I ordered the part until I receive it. This is because I asked them to make a video during the production. It comes with the glove after sales service card, protection glove, so they care about your safety. Sandblast number 80 for the finishing, and the surface quality is very good. It's two of them because they are symmetry, so I can put one here on the left and on the right of the EUC. So it will be 25mm lower than the original part. They all chamfer the edges, even though I didn't specify the chamfer, but they did it anyway. I think the quality is even better than the original part. This is a 6061T6 aluminum alloy, and it will be as strong as the original part. This is 8mm pins. It will break before this bracket, so that's how I designed this part. And there's one screw here deep inside. That is for creating a friction. It's a grub screw. They use the tip of the screw to create a friction. Push the pin out. Okay, this is steel pin. I only lower it down on the C axis. So the hole here is in the same alignment. Let's check if the pin fits. Yeah. If I mount this bracket onto the EUC, the pedal has to lay flat, so now it's flat. Contact face is used for controlling the flatness of the pedal. For the reverse engineering, it has to be very accurate, this contact face. Otherwise, the pedal will be shooting up or down. This is MX screws. Yeah, the thread is very accurate. Good quality threading. So with the grub screw in place, create a friction on the pin so that it will not fall back on itself. I think the black color would be better. First time I ordered for the black powder coat, but I want to try the laser engraving. They done a pretty good job. There's no play. Okay, there's another MX screw here that I need to put here. The thread tapping is very good. Very smooth when I turn in the thread. This we use for locking the spring. So every component works. They're using Sermoon S1 for reversing this part. It's no mistake. Just reverse using the CAD, a simple CAD software. This one I use the Audacity Inventor. I already made a video that I use FreeCAD. You can use FreeCAD to reverse this part as well. I want to make a 3D scan and check for the accuracy comparing with the original part that I designed CAD. Okay, so I'm going to scan with the Sermoon S1. Start with the global marker. I'm going to import it 0.2mm for the resolution in the parallel lines. So I'm going to make 3 scans. So the part is quite effective. Check my fridges. fusion. Going to, okay, let's align them together automatically. Okay, so it can be aligned. Let's see if it can remove low quality and the noise from the scanned meshing 1.8. Yeah, it removed the low quality mesh from the scanned. Remove isolate part 16%. Okay, now this time the isolate part is removed. You can't even see the laser engraving. Okay, next I'm going to export this as a point cloud format. And this one is the cat file that I modeled in my previous video. It's the same one that I sent to RapidDirect for CNC machining. Because this face is already aligned, so I'm going to move it along the X axis. Okay, now we have 12.2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 4. Okay, I think this is it. Oh man, this is really accurate. Look at the thin layer of the point cloud that surfaced from the solid model, even with the fillet here. Let's slice the point cloud into the thin section. Okay, if I measure the discrepancy, so it's about 36 micron earlier on this face. What about this? 47 micron here, and this one match, this one match, yeah, this one match, and in the back mounting face here, so match up. The accuracy of the machining somewhere around 36 microns. It has a very even surface, a good precision, accuracy is also good. Okay, let's put this into the EUC. I need to do a test ride. I think they over tighten the screw. They over tighten the screw that's thread into aluminum. It's very bad because you can't strip it. The screw is 12.8, it's high strength screw. But they are threading into aluminum alloy, not a steel. They can strip the thread. Okay. So this screw here is used for pushing the spring. Put this in. Okay, it's perfect. Perfect fitting. When the female thread is aluminum, even though it's the alloy aluminum, you shouldn't over tighten it. It's very dangerous for the aluminum thread to strip. Check. That's enough. Grab screws, just hold in place. Yeah, I think the control is good. Let's make a turn. It requires less force to jump up. It's easier to jump up. I like this more than the stock one. There's no clicking noise. Okay. I can do a stop and go traffic. Yeah, it's easier to climb up.